policy on urban refugees was launched jointly between the Ministry of Relief and Disaster Preparedness, as well as the African Leadership Institute. This is expected to handle challenges faced by urban refugees, such as language barriers, rejection, and number of abuses.
The urban refugees meet stressful situations. When they do, that is when the work of InterAid starts. We step in to mitigate and relieve their pain and stress through various programs, which include provision of health, provision of community services, including their protection, be it legal or otherwise.
So again, we take the Citizen Manifesto, the Women Manifesto, the People with Disabilities Manifesto, the Youth Manifestos, the demands and dreams that our citizens have.
Well aware of the mishandling of refugees by a section of police officers, State Minister for Relief and Disaster Preparedness, Musa Echweru, says all is set to form an independent police team. This as he made a commitment that no refugee will return to South Sudan despite the recent peace signing agreement.
The predicament is, do you block the border and deny them access to Uganda because there is a border in their country of origin? My humble self, we talk with the Minister of Health. Please, deploy your best personnel in Lake Albert, in Bunbujo, in Kanungu, in Kisoro. Allow refugees to come in, but make sure that we remain on a state of red alert. Look for border signs.
The minister also said no refugee will be forced to return home. Not even their countries have gained peace. The number of urban refugees in Kampala is undoubtedly increasing, currently quoted at 31,000. Report by Dias Walugembe for Urban TV.